Welcome to Mimi's Sketchbook. Today we're going to be painting this charming little view into a window. And it's reminiscent of a Matisse painting, but in that painting he's looking out the window, but he's got that fun little goldfish bowl there. So come along with me as we paint this little picture. Welcome. And today we're going to be drawing a window. When I'm drawing a building, I want it to be square with the sides of the paper. So I want to make sure my lines are parallel to the edge of the paper. So I'm going to just make sure. Otherwise, our building would be lopsided and ready to fall down and a little bit disturbing to look at. Now, I am drawing the window in first. And this is a little header on it just to give it some weight at the top. And then I'm going to draw some shutters here. And I'm going to put, because the shutters are swinging out towards me, I'm going to put an angle on them. So this angles up, this part angles down. And I'm going to put the edge here. That's going to be horizontal. This edge is horizontal to the top and the bottom. And this, these two ends of the shutter are parallel to the edge of the paper. I'm going to put a little line here and a little line here. And now I'm going to put in the louvers. And the louvers fan out like my fingers, like this. They're closer at this end and wider at this end. So I'm going to start here. And as they get to the center, it's going to be straight. Then they're going to start to fan up so it's parallel to this. So can you see that fan? And that gives us a sense of depth. So let's do it again on this side. I'm going to angle the shutter out and draw this edge coming down. This is the width of the shutter. This is the depth of it right here. And this is parallel to the bottom. This is parallel to the top, which is the same. And these lines are parallel to the edge of the paper, as is this one. Okay, now I'm going to put the little edges that are where the louvers are inset, and now I'm going to, this is parallel to here. Let me just clean this up a little bit so it's easier to see. So this first louver, the top of the louvers are going to be parallel. I'm going to flare them out like this again. And when I get to the center, it's going to be straight out. Put one here. And then I'm going to flare them out till they get to this angle right here, parallel to the bottom of the louver. Now, do you see how that looks like it's coming towards us? That's how we create a sense of depth here in our picture. One way we do it. Okay, so let's dress up our window. And on some older buildings, there's all kinds of beautiful decorations. So I'm just going to start in the middle, I think. Start with a little curve here. And I'm going to just kind of flare it out like this, like it's maybe bricks inset, or, man, I could have done that better. Should start in the middle with it. The center one is called a keystone. I'm going to start with the keystone. Make sure that's angled correctly. There you go. And just divide it like this. So it's a lot simpler. Okay, there we go. And I can outline these a little bit so they look like there's maybe mortar in there. And this is just a little nifty decoration here on the top of the window. Just something else to jazz up our design. So here's this. And now we are going to be looking into this room here. And I want to create a little passageway by putting in some curtains. We're looking through the windows, and then we're going to be looking through the draperies and focusing on what's inside. So how about if we kind of take an image, a famous image from Matisse, where he is looking, not in the window, but out a window. And he has on his table a fish tank. Let's put a fish tank here. And we're going to just kind of see if that's our water. Let's put a couple of simple little fish, a couple little goldfish swimming around. Three little goldfish. That's plenty for that size room. Maybe I'll just bring the curtains out a little bit more. Here's a little tie, a little detail. And I might want to put a little fringe on here. Might not show up too much, but I could do that. And a pattern. I don't know what pattern yet. But I also want to put in here a window box. So I am just going to, this would be the opening of the window box. And I'm not even going to see this bottom, but I'm just showing you what it would be like. Okay, now let's do just a real simple basic flower that's overhanging the outside of this window. So I am just going to put a suggestion of a flower. That's all these are. We're not here in this to do real live flowers. This is just a decorative painting. And let's put another little colored flower here. Let's do daisy kind of flowers. Just suggestions of them. So we're looking, we're sending the viewer to look over the top of these flowers into this room. And it creates kind of a journey for the viewer, like they're getting to eavesdrop on what's happening. We have greens spilling out here. Should be a little heavier at the top. And we can have some vines. Sometimes I don't think these out ahead of time. I just have to adjust in this as I go along. So we'll make a bigger one here. So it's overflowing and it looks beautiful and lush. So here is our view, and we have to look, we're looking into this maybe apartment building or cottage window. Don't know what it is, but it's whatever your imagination thinks of. So this is a little empty up here. I'm thinking. And it's very busy right here. So, hey, I'm going to just move my... should have probably done it different, but this is no big deal. I'm going to move my table, suggesting a round table. Here, I'll move this tall fish tank up here. Here's the water again. And let's... and in a fish tank, you actually will see through the clear water, so you would see the back of the tablecloth. These fish have gotten bigger. I don't know what kind of fish that is. Okay, so that's a little bit better. I've got... so I've got that a little bit straightened out, and none of these extra lines matter because I'm going to go in with, let's use a marker. This is an ultra fine point Sharpie, but you can get something finer to use. There's all kinds of things you can use. You can use a micron that's very fine. Or I even like to use a black ballpoint pen. It works just fine, and I usually have one around, but not today. So that's what I'm going to do. So now I'm going to just come in here and ink my picture. Choose the parts that I want. And when I ink, I don't want to have a real hard line. I'm just kind of lightly skimming over the lines, not pushing down. I'm holding my marker very lightly, and kind of lifting every now and then. If I pushed completely down on this pen, it would give a much thicker, darker line. And I just want to suggest the lines. I don't necessarily want the lines to be dark and heavy. Okay, so that looks good for now, and let's just clean it up. I'm going to use a kneaded eraser. Clean this up. It always looks so much better after we get rid of all the pencil lines. And it's not perfect, but that's not what I'm going for. I'm just going for creating a sense of a light sketch, watercolor. Light, sketchy, fun watercolor. So this is my watercolors here. And I just use this little spritzer to activate them. Which way I'm going to go? I think I'm going to start with the water here. Let's kind of do a blue and yellow theme. It could be fun. Bright and pretty. And I could take a little bit darker color and just kind of suggest a little depth here. Not much, just a little bit like that. And I think I'll find a little different blue here, a little turquoise. Actually, the shutters on my house are turquoise. And I'm using very little paint. This is a tiny painting, so you don't need much. And you can use any kind of paint set. The important thing in a painting, the most important thing, paints are, everything's important. And everything will help you get a better painting, the better supplies. But if you need to paint or spend your money in one area, spend it on paper. Get the best watercolor paper you can get. Okay, there's that. And I think I'm just going to make my house just a real subtle background color. It's a little dark, but that doesn't bother me because I will just come in here and add some water. Kind of use this as my paints and dip from here. So this is looking like a stone cottage, maybe? Or a city apartment. And a good paper, I can move the paint around like this. It doesn't absorb, it sits on the top of the paper. And it's very easy to manipulate, and it works with you and not against you. And so that's a really important thing when you're painting with watercolors, is you want the paint to be floating in water on top of the paper. You don't want it too much water, you don't want too little water, but the more you paint, the more you'll be able to judge what's just right for the paint to move around on its own and have a nice even surface. So underneath these flowers, it should be just a little bit darker because the flowers are casting a shadow, and that shadow, even though it's dark here, it will help to contrast with the flowers and make them pop out and seem brighter. So I'm going to put some darker paint up here. So these pop. It just takes a little while to paint around the flowers, but if I relax, I enjoy this. You want it darkest right up here under the flowers, so I can go back up and do this. And then, to blend it, I'm going to wet my brush, clean out that dark paint, and I'm just going to touch this paint here, and it's going to rejuvenate it, rehydrate it, and it just blends right out. Just fades. I can take it and it will just fade this from dark to light. Here. I can do the same here. So now we've created the shade underneath the flowers. I don't know what I'm going to do up here yet. I want a little contrast, but I want detail up there, but I don't want it to take away from the main show that's here. So let's see. If I want to think about color and the transition of it, I know, let's see, let's paint these yellow, because I know I want this yellow and blue theme. So I'll start with a little bit lighter yellow. And I'm going to go back in and put a little darker yellow in the center. Maybe even a touch of orange, just to create that sense of depth. And these are, this is a little bit wet, so this orange is just going to spread out, gently spread out, and create this very gentle little shading in the center. So let's go to a back to our blue, and maybe we'll go to a little bit of purpley blue color for these flowers, so we have a different so we've got a turquoise and we've got the kind of cerulean on the and let's add just a little touch of blue in the center. So that has a little bit of, and I'm skipping the green because this is still wet. And if I touch this right now, it will, could possibly bleed into my flowers. I'm just going to put a dark color right here, so it shows a little bit of darkness in there. That's all. Creates a little more contrast. A yellow. Oh, I'm living dangerous here, painting right next to this yellow. But, oh well, that's what I do. I'm impatient. Alrighty, now I think I'm just going to make this a little bit of a shadow back in here. I don't want to be worrying about detail behind this curtain that is a mystery. So I'm just going to not expose anything or worry about that. And because this is transparent, I'm just going to put a little bit of that blue showing through the fish tank. And then this is the reflected surface. So I'm just going to leave that suggesting a little lighter edge there. Could lighten that up a bit right here, but there. Okay, so now we've got this in here, and what color are we going to paint this tablecloth? So let's go with just a little bit deeper. We need contrast here. Stay away from those flowers. We have to go back when all that dries. Let's come up here and just give this a little different value. I'm going to just go kind of a gray, and just a touch of black with a lot of water. Let's see, just so it's not bright white. We want this to tone this down a little bit. So it's just add a little bit of that warmer. That warmer tone to it. Leave some white spots. Gives it a little bit of a... Just went over my white spot. Gives a little bit of a sparkle. Okay, now let's see. If I turn this in the light, I can see what's wet and what's dry. And I want to focus on these goldfish, so I'm going to make them a nice bright orange, like that. And I think this is dry enough down here, so we can paint in some green. That seems to pop out a lot better. I like it. And the vines look better as a blue or green. Looking at this, this could be done. It's a cute little picture and it would make a fun gift card. But I think I need a little more detail to compete with this, to kind of frame the fish tank. So I'm going to come up with a little pattern on the curtains. And what's it going to be? First of all, I want to see if my curtains are dry. They're dry. No shine on them, so I'm safe to paint on top of them. So I'm thinking I could do polka dots, little polka dots. Or I could do plaid. I could do this way or this way, make it a plaid. But I think I'm going to do a tiny little stripe. And I could get a different paintbrush. But you can paint nice and thin with a paintbrush. If I hold this up like this, I can make a nice thin line. So I'm going to go along with the follow the contour of my draperies. That added some, I think, just the right amount of detail to contrast with this, to compete with them. That looks pretty good. Now I can also, because I just like to paint, put a little shading in here if I want, underneath these. To add a little more. Subtle interest to the picture. This really isn't about being perfect. I just like to paint a little bit more. But I don't want to go too far. So I think that might be it. I guess I could put some pattern around here. I don't know. Sometimes I have to know when to stop. So I've got this blue here. And this would frame it very nicely. What do you think? So I took a look at this and decided that my flowers down here were a little dark and needed to be brightened up. So I used this, it's called a Uniball Signo Jelly Roll Pen, and it's white, to come in here and lighten these up, to brighten them up a little bit. And I think that looks better, just a little brighter, a little more contrast. It pops them forward and makes everything else recede. And I gave this a little bit more detail up here also. So this is the finished picture, but I want to show you some other examples that I did. So here's a few different paintings that I did. And here's the one we just did. This one has a kitty cat on it. And the kitty's sitting on a blue chair. I have a different style of window shutters and a different style of a window box. It's the wire type with kind of a, what do they call it? A cocoa shell type liner in it. And this is has a bird in it, in a bird cage, which is fun. And here's one, much like the first one we did, different flowers, same blue, but I put a different top on it. I like that top a lot. So what will you come up with? I'd love it if you'd post some. I'm always thrilled to see what other people come up with. So thank you for watching Mimi's Sketchbook. Please give it a like if you enjoyed this. Share it with your friends. And please subscribe. And also, I'm going to put a list of all the supplies I used below, and it's a direct link to Amazon if you want to try them. So thanks a lot, and till next time. Bye.